Hi everyone, and welcome back to our channel. In today's video, we're going to take a look at the workflow engine-based Odoo module developed by Openinside. A workflow engine is a module or tool that manages business processes. It is a key component in any ERP system. A workflow engine manages and monitors the state of activities in a workflow, such as the processing and approval of an employee contract, and determines which new activity to transition to according to defined processes. Openinside's workflow engine is a specially designed module to help users enforce a series of recurring tasks that make up a business process or a workflow. The workflow engine is a highly configurable module where almost no real coding is required to design any complicated processes. This tutorial includes two sections. Section 1 is about how to configure the module, and Section 2 is about the functionality of the module. In this section, we will present how to configure the workflow engine-based module. The best part? There is no need for code deployment when adding or modifying workflows. Let's get started with our demo. Start by clicking on the Settings menu, where you'll find the Workflow option in the main navigation bar. Here, you will see a list of the extensions I have already installed. In this video, we will take the Sales Order workflow as an example. When you navigate to the record, you will notice a Reset Static States button. Clicking on it will automatically populate the table with default states. The workflow engine automatically plugs in those states as default. If you find that any of them are not needed, you can deactivate them. Furthermore, you will find a reject state column that indicates whether a state is considered a rejected state or not. In addition to this, there is a type column which offers two different types. Next, we have the name column, which contains the display name of the state. You can edit or modify it to better align with your specific requirements. Finally, there is a technical name column. It is recommended not to change the technical name since it might be used in functions. If you wish to add a static state, you can do so by clicking Add a Line. This will allow you to further customize your workflow to meet your specific needs. The following tabs allow you to execute actions and functions using Python code based on trigger options. For example, code added in the Submit tab will run upon clicking the Confirm button. The On Approval tab allows you to execute actions for states between the draft and final states. Please note that there are two predefined variables: the old state that represents the current state, while the new state is the next state. Code added in on approve would run once the record enters the final state of the workflow. Please note that if you decide to add code in on approve, you need to call the on approve function as follows. Similarly for on reject, on forward, on return, and on transfer. Another functionality is the show action approved all option. When enabled, it adds an approval option in the action of the workflow model. Multiple records can be selected and approved simultaneously. You'll notice the workflow smart button, which shows the workflow stages within this model. Currently, we only have one stage, which is the default stage created during the extension installation. Now, when you go into the configuration of the stage and navigate to the right section, you'll find the following key options. We begin with the technical name of the stage, which is used in Python code, followed by the display name that is shown in the record. Next, there is the Allow Forward option. This feature enables you to forward the record to one of the users within the group you've selected in the Approval Groups tab. Following that, you'll find the Allow Return option. This functionality permits you to return the record to any previous stages from your current position in the workflow. Next, we have Allow Transfer to allow you to transfer to any of the next stages from your current position in the workflow. Next, there is the Allow Cancel option. Activating this option provides two options. Cancel, Automatic. This will take you directly to the cancel stage. Cancel Workflow activates a separate workflow specifically designed for the cancellation process. To configure this cancellation workflow, simply return to the list of workflows and locate a record named Cancellation Record. Here, you can create the necessary stages for handling the cancellation process. Going back to our workflow and stage configuration, we have the Schedule Activity option. When checked, it will create activities for the approval users for this stage. You can customize the creation date of these activities by selecting trigger fields in the Schedule Activity field or adjusting the due date of activities by adding a specific number of days in the Activity Days field. The activities created for the users will be shown from this icon. Moving to the left section, you will first encounter the Sequence field, where you can adjust the sequence number to control the order of stages within the workflow. The Add Followers option automatically includes approval users as followers for the record. The Post-Approval Message and Post-Reject Message options allow you to add the reason for approval or rejection in the chatter of the record. The Tags field serves as information for filtering and grouping purposes. If a workflow stage has the Automatic Approval option, the system will bypass the stage if one of the current stage's approvals was the approval of the previous step. Lastly, the Approve as Super User option bypasses any security restrictions. The required condition is used to determine when the stage should be entered. If the condition is true, the stage will always be entered. You can customize the condition to meet your requirements using Python code. Moving on to the tabs below. The first tab is Approval Groups. You can select the relevant groups for approval for this stage. The Filter tab allows you to filter the users of the approval group selected using Python code. The third tab is Mail Templates, where you can choose the email template that will be sent once you enter the stage. The fourth tab is Reject Mail Templates, where you can choose the email template that will be sent when the record is rejected. The fifth tab is Buttons. You'll notice the Required Reason option. When activated, providing a reason for approval or rejection becomes mandatory. Additionally, you can customize the names of the reject and approve buttons in the button name field. The confirm message can also be modified as needed. If you want to hide the button, you can simply remove the button name. The last tab, Escalation, can be used to trigger actions such as sending a reminder, emails, auto-approve, etc. You can choose when to execute the action by modifying the delay duration. We hope this section helps you figure out how to configure and deploy your workflow in Odoo. In the following section of this demo, we will present the functionality of the Workflow Engine-based module. Now, we will see how the workflow works in the Sales module. First, click on New to create a quotation. Then select the customer. Add the product. Then, save. After we save it, the workflow stages will appear. We can set validations on any field as needed. Here, we have a validation which will not allow the user to proceed unless the expiration date is selected. So we will enter the expiration date. Save it. And click on Confirm. As you can see, the stage has changed from Draft to Sales Manager. These are the workflow stages. And here are the action buttons. Here, we have another example of validation on the payment terms. We will select the payment term in this field. For example, 2 months. Then save. As you can see, a new stage appeared, Payment Term Control, based on a predefined condition. Also, we can set a condition on the total amount. For example, if it's less than $1,000, it will go to a specific workflow. If it's more than $1,000, it will go to another workflow. In case any modification is needed, we can return to the stage. Or we can forward the access to any user within the approval group. We can also reject or cancel the quotation. Now we will proceed with the quotation approval. Now the quotation is approved. And there you have it. You've reached the end of our tutorial on the workflow engine base module developed by Openinside. We hope this video has given you a clear vision of how to configure this module and the module's functionality. If you enjoyed this video and want to explore more of Openinside's Odoo module tutorials, be sure to subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell to stay updated. Thank you, and see you in our next video.